is up, awesome people, and welcome back to my Pokemon Trading Card Game Online Card Opening Series. So in the last episode, we continued opening up the Dragon's Exalted Booster Packs that I had. However, in this episode, I want to take a quick detour away from opening up the Dragon's Exalted Booster Decks. I'm actually going to open up the Kalos Starter Decks that you get, the X and Y series. So I'm going to be up the Chespin, Froakie and Fennekin starter packs. So for that we need to head to the redemption page, and here we go again. I'm going to have to manually enter these things, so you have to forgive me if a few bugs occur. So the first one we're entering is the Chespin deck, so I'm going to do these one at a time. So it's going to redeem that one, and there we go, there's the Chespin deck. It's a bundle pack. So let's go open. And righty, so in this deck we're going to get a holo Chestnut, and it's got 150 health. It's a grass card. Its first move is Needle Arm, which deals 50 damage, requires 1 grass energy and 2 energy cards of any type. Its last move is Tumbling Attack, which deals 80 plus damage, requires 2 grass energies and 2 energy cards of any type. And Flip a Coin, if heads, the attack does 40 more damage, which is quite powerful. You got 2 of them, one was holo, one was normal. Followed up by 4 Quinlans and 4 Chespins. Then you got 2 Pantsages, 2 Weedles, and you got Gramble. So Gramble is Fairy with 100 health. It's got Headbutt, deals 30 damage, requires 1 Fairy Energy and 1 Energy card of any type. Which is funny, I thought they would have been too colorous. And its last move is Double Stomp, 50 plus damage, requires 1 Fairy Energy and 2 Energy cards of any type. Again, I thought Gramble would have been all energy cards of any type for a second. Guess not. Flip 2 coins, the attack does 20 more damage for each head. So it's a pretty risky card to play, but if you can get the heads, it's worthwhile. Followed up by 4 Snubbles as well. You got Slurpuff, you got Snorlax, who's usually pretty good. 120 health, it's a colorless card. Rock Smash, 10 plus damage, requires 3 energy cards of any type. Flip a coin, if heads, the attack does 30 more damage, and Strength, which deals 70 damage, requires 4 energy cards of any type. So that is a basic card as well. It doesn't evolve from Munchlax or anything. We've also got Miltank, who has 100 health, colorless card. It has Sit Down Splash, 50 plus damage, requires 3 energy cards of any type. Flip a coin, if heads, the attack does 20 more damage. So we also got Bunnelby. I've got a potion. Okay, that's a bit weird. We got Potion, who's being revamped in design again. That looks like Switch, which it is. We got Pokeball. I honestly prefer the old designs compared to that. We got Tyramo. Oh, I don't know if I said that right. Draw 3 cards. So here's like the newer version of Sharon. So eventually, when the old boost decks die out, he will replace Sharon as far as League ability in tournaments. And then you also got a Grass Energy and Fairy Energy cards, plus a Chespin token you can use in gameplay as well, which is pretty sweet. Alright, so that's the first deck. The next one we'll open up is the Froakie deck. So I'll just grab the code for that one. And we'll redeem that one. Alright, so the Froakie bundle pack. So let's open up you. So same thing as the Chespin one, we'll get 2 freaking final evolutions. So it's Annoying Greninja, 1 holo, 1 normal. This one's got different moves to the other Greninja I picked up. It's got 140 health, obviously it's a water card. It's got Mat Block, 40 damage, requires 1 water energy card. Flip a coin, if heads, discard an energy attached to your opponent's active Pokemon, which is pretty handy, I will admit. And Aqua Edge, which deals 80 damage, requires 2 water energy cards and 1 energy card of any type. No extra effect there on that one. That is a lot better than the other Greninja I picked up, and it actually requires a little bit of energy to pull it off, which is, yeah, probably a little bit better. Plus, it's got better moves too, I will admit that too. 4 Frogadiers and 4 Froakies. Then we've got 2 Panspores, 2 Chlorizes. Where the hell is their final evolutions? That sucks. Got 2 Bishops, Steel Energy card, Steel card, 90 health. Wicked Jab, which deals 20 damage, requires 1 Steel Energy card. Flip a coin, appears your opponent's active Pokemon is now paralyzed, which is pretty cool. And Metal Claw, which deals 70 damage, requires 1 Steel Energy card and 2 Energy cards of any type. So that's a pretty decent card, needless to say. Four Ponyards. Ew, Honedge. Two Honedges. Haha, we got Farfetch. Awesome. 70 health. Not colorless card, and it's only got Slash. Haha. We got Skitty as well. We've got, looks like Beedoof. Yep, Beedoof looks awesome. It's got a good move too. 70 health, it's a colorless card, and rollout deals 60 damage, requires 3 energy cards of any type. That's a bit rough, but it's got a lot of power. We then followed up with Crushing Hammer. Flip a coin if heads has got an energy attached to one of your opponent's Pokemon, which is pretty handy and can be quite game changing. We've got Switch again, we've got Pokeball, we've got Oh god. This is one of the names I couldn't pronounce during the X and Y playthrough. It's Tiramo or something like Tyrano. I'm not gonna try now. We got Water Energy plus Steel Energy as well, plus a Froakie coin, which is pretty cool. Alrighty, so that's that deck, and we've got one left, which is the Fennekin deck. Where is Fennekin? One second, I seem to have lost my Fennekin card. Alright, so I thought I had the Fennekin starter deck, but it turns out I don't. I just rechecked all my codes and I don't actually have it. So I'm going to have to cover the Fennekin starter deck in another episode. So just to finish the episode off, we'll continue opening up the Dragon's Exalted booster packs. Alright, so we'll start off with our first one, and we're going to get Electrike Nosepass, a alternative art Electrike, Houndour, Swablu. We got a Blend Energy, a De-Evolution Spray, Rescue Scarf, Reverse Holo Gabi, and Garchomp as the rare, and I think you're holo. Well, normally it is a holo, but I guess not. Alright, so the next one we are going to get... Dino, Yanma, Ampom, Slakoth, Trubbish, Zwellius, an alternative art Zwellius, Toolscrapper, yep, and Reverse Holo Aggron plus a Wailord as the rare. Right, so we got 129 left of these. Sweet. We got Tynepole, Magikarp, Electrike, Boltoy, Mareep, Palpitoad, Throw, Skiplume, Reverse Holo Murkrow, and Ambipom. Sweet, we got one we didn't have. Oh, nice. So I got Boltoy, Trubbish, Ampom, Spheal, Wurmple, Durant, Vigoroth, Dino, Hydreigon Reverse Holo, and we got Terrakion EX as our rare. So oh, I should have looked at it there. Whoopsies, I'm using the old method. Alright, so the next one we're getting Magikarp, Boltoy, Drifloon, Mareep, Gothita, Flaffy, Laron, Sork, Magikarp Reverse Holo, and Golurk as the rare. Okay, so next booster pack. Hi, oh, nice, 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 awesome. Nosepass, Gothita, Gible, Electrike, Yanmark, Giant Cape, Gotharita, Celio, Reverse Holo Boltoy, and Registeel as our EX card and rare. Awesome. Alright, so I'm just going to quickly take a detour and go to filters. We just did Dragon's Exalted, didn't we? Alright, so I'm just going to have a quick look through here. First one up, well, knock off that one. Stupid glitch. Alright, so we got Registeel and Terrakion. So that'll be all the way in the R's and T's, unfortunately. We got Murkrow Reverse Holo, so I'm going to knock that off on there. Murkrow. Sweet, it's Murkrow I used too. We just went past one. Registeel EX, so it's a steel card with 180 health. Its first move is Triple Laser, which has 3 energy cards of any type. This attack does 30 damage to 3 of your opponent's benched opponent's Pokemon. So that obviously should be benched Pokemon. Unless it's 3 Pokemon of any type, but it's sounding like 3 benched Pokemon to me, since it says don't apply weakness and resistance to benched Pokemon. And its last move is Protect Charge, which deals 80 damage, requires 2 steel energy cards and 2 energy cards of any type. During your opponent's next turn, any damage done to this Pokemon by attacks is reduced by 20 after applying weakness and resistance. So that's a pretty, well, that's a pretty good card, actually, I will admit that, since Protect Charge does reduce moves by 20. And you can deal 30 damage to 3 Pokemon of your choice, too. Which can take up bench Pokemon, which I've said those moves are quite strong if used properly. And the other card we got was Terrakion EX, which has 180 health. It's a fighting card. First move is Rock Tumble, which deals 50 damage, requires 1 fighting energy and 1 energy card of any type. This attack's damage isn't affected by resistance, which is really cool. And its last move is Pump Up Smash, which deals 90 damage, requires 2 fighting energy cards and 1 energy card of any type. Attach 2 basic energy cards from your hand to your bench Pokemon in any way you like. Now, I like moves like that. That's a really good support move. Alrighty, so yes, that's the end of this episode. I'm sorry for buggering up and thinking I had a deck that I don't actually have. So as I said, I'll cover that a bit later on. So anyways, that's the end of this episode. In the next episode, we'll cover a few other rarities. Again, leaning away from the booster packs. I didn't actually want to do the booster packs this episode, but kind of forced to do that, unfortunately, to make up for not having something. So anyways, until the next episode, this is Lady Crimson saying ciao for now, but not forever. Ciao!